All righty. Let's go back to the Gilly Crane hotline. Gilly Crane, with any size crane for any size job. Rick Throneberry joins us here on the Friday Night Thunder Scoreboard Show. Rick, we talked to you in the post game, and for those of folks that didn't hear it, first of all, shame on them. But you talked about how good Cornersville was. They really brought all of their ammunition to Lynchburg tonight, didn't they?
Yeah, they did, Dennis. The game started out sloppy, very sloppy for the Raiders. They fumbled it three straight times. Cornersville, on their first touchdown, the quarterback actually fumbled the ball coming away from the center, and it looked like that Moore County's defense kind of just stopped and was watching the action as a couple of the players dove for it. But the ball bounced right back up into, they started out with McAhon as the quarterback, and it bounced right back up to his hand, and he took off, and it was a 70-yard touchdown. They tried the extra point, and it was miserably bad. And then two more turnovers by the Raiders there in the first quarter, and it was quickly 22-0. Moore County couldn't get anything going on offense. Cornersville Bulldogs had the answer for those jet sweeps with Cashin that has worked so well the first two ball games, but their speed on the corners and linebackers was really telling tonight, Dennis, as Moore County just couldn't get anything going offensively, and then they couldn't stop the Bulldogs on offense at all. I mean, it was really bad.
We're talking to Rick Throneberry. He is the voice of Cat Country and the Moore County Blue Raiders for WHMT in Tullahoma. As tonight, Moore County falls to Cornersville, actually shut out by Cornersville. Were the sloppy field conditions, did that hurt the wing tee attack of Moore County?
Well, they both run the same offense, Dennis. It was amazing that the Bulldogs had no trouble hanging on to the ball, but Moore County just could not hold on to it there in the first half. Now, they did come out in the third quarter, and they kept the ball the entire quarter. Unfortunately, though, they didn't score. And then they had it down in the Bulldog territory as time ran out. But, as you know, Dennis, the clock runs when it gets that kind of a score, and Moore County just couldn't get it done tonight on that wet field.
Dennis Weaver, Eric Keith talking to Rick Throneberry, the voice of the Moore County Blue Raiders on WHMT Cat Country. Eric?
All right. Cannon County, that you're heading there next week. So how hopeful are you for a bounce back against a struggling Cannon County team?
Well, the second half really was a whole lot different, guys. Moore County, like I said, held on to the ball the entire quarter of the third quarter. They took the kickoff, but unfortunately they just couldn't score tonight. Cashin, Sweeten, and Schuler, the main guys, Nate Love was still out. If they could have moved the game to tomorrow, the two transfers from Tullahoma from last year would have been eligible to play tomorrow, but that was not to be because they went ahead and played tonight. But yeah, I mean, I just think they just got shell-shocked there when they fell down 22-0, and they saw that Cashin and Sweeten and Schuler just could not get to the corners as they had done the first two games. And I think they were just shell-shocked that they couldn't get anything going at all.
So you're going to get a couple of new ones next week as you go to Woodbury.
Yep.
Good luck in preparation for that, bub friend.
And Dennis, let me tell you, the guy that started last year at tailback from Tullahoma in those first couple of games, he was really productive. I mean, he's a big old bruising, kind of like a Kirk Watson kind of guy back in the 70s. You young people, old people know about who I'm talking about. So, I mean, that's what they really did tonight, Dennis, but you know, somebody that could just pound it and pound it and pound it. And as I said in the opening, that's what I really look for Moore County to do, because that's all they've done. But the wing tee, it didn't work tonight against the Bulldogs from Cornersville.
And the Bulldogs wing tee.
Yeah, it was a mirror image. I mean, it's kind of like what Coffey County ran a couple of years ago all the time, where the rudders are actually like tight ends.
Yep.
And they'll just crisscross, and then they'll have a tailback or a fullback, and they take it to those three guys, and they possessed a lot of speed that I also don't think at Moore County realized that they had.
All right, Rick, we appreciate your time, buddy, and good luck in your preparations. Have fun in Woodbury, okay?
I will. Maybe we'll get together later for that steak.
Maybe we will. Maybe we won't. You too, Rick. We'll talk to you soon. Oh, that's Rick Throneberry. Fortunately, he gets to eat off the child's menu. He's so small.
There you go.